G'day, I'm Steve. Welcome to my workshop. This is Woodworking Masterclass and it's part 5 of the 6-part project of building a 4-foot by 3-foot bookcase. What we've done so far with this bookcase is we've dadoed the sides, we've fitted the shelves, we've put the back on, we've put the cover strips on. What I want to do on this episode is do some routing on the cover strips. We'll fit the stretchers on the top and the bottom, and I'll show you how you can lend a little bit more detail to your build if you want to be a little bit adventurous. Now what I'm going to do is use a core box bit. Is this little chappy here, and that'll give me a nice hollow sort of trench. Make sure that you don't hit the nails. What you've got to decide is just how long these router flutes are going to be. So I'll get one of the stretchers and I'll just roughly guesstimate what looks good to me about there. And we're going to put the same on the bottom. So I might have that going a little bit further down. I might have that one about there. So that's 42 mil wide. So if I go 21 mil, that's fine. Now what I'll do is line up the axis of this cutter bit to line up with the center of this board. And also the depth will denote how deep this goes, and I don't want it to go too deep because if it does, it really sticks out. But I just want a nice subtle something to break the monotony of a square bit of timber. Put on some eye and ear protection. So I'm going to start a little bit up from this mark here, and then I can come back down onto it, turn it on, and then lower it gently onto the job. Now I've got a nice smooth groove down there. I'll do the same to the other side. That's taken care of the fluting on the cover strips. Now we have to put a stretcher on the top and one on the bottom. I'll do the bottom one first because I want to have a bit of fun with the top one. Just grab a piece of pine. Now I like to have it down, oh, just a half a mil or something. I don't want it directly butted up with the shelf. I'd like it down just a little bit. That way I can just arris the edge of that shelf. But again, if you prefer it dead square with the shelf, put it dead square with the shelf. And I'm going to skew nail these into the side. So I'll put a couple of drill holes, start off at a bit of an angle. And if you ever bend a nail, put a new nail in because it'll break your heart trying to straighten the other one. Then with the nail punch, just ride the head home. Now what I'm going to do is put the skirting on, or moulding on the bottom. But before I do that, I want to plug these holes up and sand them off, because it's going to be a lot easier doing that than trying to fill them once the moulding's on. If you remember last episode, I used masking tape to surround the area I was going to putty. And again, I'm using this putty. But what you do with holes is get a nail, or in this case a punch, poke it through and fold the masking tape over where you've poked it through. So you've actually got just a little hole there. So it's so easy now to putty nail holes. You just put that hole over where you want to putty, pull it off, go to the next one, putty it, pull it off. But in the meantime, we'll move up to this top stretcher. What you can do is, if you want exactly the same as you did at the bottom, just get a square dressed piece of timber and lay it across the top like that, and it will suffice. It'll do the job. Another thing you can do is run it over the router and put a round over bit on it, which gives it a nice piece of shape. But what I want to do is actually put a design into here, which really lifts the cabinet and makes it a little bit different to the ordinary. So what I'm going to do is I'll take you step by step how I make a stencil and then how I make a template, and we'll actually cut a design into this top piece before we actually insert it into the bookcase. So first things off, I need to find the center of this board. By the way, if you haven't got a ruler that's long enough to actually find the center of something, in this case, that's around 850, I've got a 600 ruler. Just measure, if you know that's around 800, measure just over 400. So here I'll go 420. Then I'll measure 420 from this side. And those two marks there are pretty darn close. And you just intersect that. And that's going to be pretty darn close to the center of your board. And what I think I'll do, I'll come in about 70 mil from the ends. That means that that center mark, I want to be 35 mil each side. All right. So there are my three marks. And I want that shape to come up here and then down here and repeat itself here. But before I actually chop into it, I have to work out how much room I can actually go up. Because don't forget, when this is in situ, this is going to be the top. So the moulding is going to be sitting there. So really, I've only got that much space from there to there to put the design in. And I'm going to router it, which means if I router it, I'm also going to lose another half an inch, maybe three quarters of an inch with the moulding. I'll bring it down, I think another half an inch, which is going to be to there. So now I've got to work out what diameter I want there to line up with this hole. Now, I couldn't even tell you what size hole that is. I'll measure it if you want. That was a 35 mil force and a bit, or inch and, is it inch and a quarter? Close enough. 35 mil or inch and a quarter. Now that's given me a nice round circle. I can then place that here to get an idea of the curve that I want. And if you don't have that size, it doesn't matter. You can go to the pantry and get a small jam jar or a mustard jar or something, anything that's round, and just put it on here and draw the radiuses until you get something that pleases you. Yeah, I like that. So now if I take this up to the center, that's 6 1/4, about there. So basically that's the shape I'm looking for, up around here, up here, and then back down there, and then we repeat that radius again. Now I'm going to do this with a router and a bandsaw, so I'll show you how to make the template up. Scrap bit of MDF. Providing I've got one straight edge, I'm happy. I'll go and re-drill this hole, but I'll make sure that I drill it close to the edge, so that way I can get a nice radius and I've got a straight edge to go to. As you can see, I've drilled very, very close to the edge there. Now with a square, just mark a line from the outer edge of that circumference up, and then measure from that line you've just drawn along whatever the space is, half of the space. In this case, it's 6 1/4. So I just mark that there. And then transfer how far from this edge deep you're going to go. We've measured half the distance that we want to put the design in, and also the total depth from the bottom of the stretcher up to where you feel comfortable having the top of your design, which is there. And then grab a ruler and go from this corner here, which is the highest point of your design, down to the highest point of the circle. So you've got that shape happening there. Now, I'm going over to the bandsaw to cut the waste out. If you don't have a bandsaw, by all means use a coping saw, a fret saw. I wouldn't do it, try it on the table saw. Even a back saw or a file. Or with MDF, you could use a knife. I'll be back in a tick. All right, as you can see, I've cut the unwanted part of the circle. I've cut on the inside or right on the pencil line and down there. And you just give it a little bit of a clean up. Now, transfer this onto something a little bit thicker. Here's some 1/4 inch MDF. Now, I've allowed 70 mil on the stretcher before the design starts. So come in at 80 mil if you like, 80 or 90 mil, it doesn't really matter, make it 100 mil. And draw a line across. And then line up this edge here, because it's a little bit of fatness we've got, onto that line. And bring this around so it's square, and just draw that in. As you can see, I've now cut on the inside of that line of the template. Now with some double-sided tape, I'm going to reposition this to make sure you can just see the pencil line on the inside. Push it down, and I'm going to use one of these. Now when I set this up, this bearing will run on the top section of MDF, and it will follow that shape, and the cutter, which are these little lands on the side, will cut the underneath substrate I've got there, but it'll give me an exact pattern of what I've got on top. So now, when I peel this off, there's 1/2 of the template, but we want to have mirror images. So what I'll do now, grab another piece of tape, only this time, put it on the other side. So now if I line this up with this, and have this square, once again, draw it. Take the waste, main part of the waste out with the bandsaw, and then I'll do it on the router, and we'll have a look at the finished product when I've done that. Now the only bit we have to worry about is just this little titbit in here where the 2 halves came together. And I'll just clean that up with a chisel. A bit of a rub with sandpaper. We've got a design that's symmetrical. What we've got to do is mark out. This is 70 mil from the edge. So from this point here, mark back 70 mil. Just there. We go and dock that on the saw. Now it's a case of just drawing it onto the stretcher, cutting out the waste, double-sided tape, put the template in place, cut it out using that profile cutter, which we'll do. Take this off. Always get this tape off because it stays on there for a couple of days. It's impossible to get off. And there we have a nice little design that just makes a bookcase look a little bit different to a standard bookcase with just a straight edge, I suppose. Again, you can either leave this square, you can round it over with a spoke shave, you could clean it up with sandpaper, really whatever you want to do. I'm actually going to use a round over bit, and I'll round over it, which will give it a nice soft feel, but I'll also round over the back. That way we've got a nice curve going all the way through. I'll show you what I mean. I'll do one side and then show you what it looks like, and then I'll do the other side, and you be the judge of what works best for you. That's a round over just on one side, but you've still got this sharp edge under here. So what I'm going to do is round over on that side too, and it really just gives it a nice finished appeal, I think. It really softens the edges, and that'll fit in there quite nicely. But because of its shape, I'll hand sand this, because if I start using an orbital sander or a random orbital sander, I'm going to change the flow of the design. Now these pencil marks I've got on here too. A mistake I see a lot of woodworkers do is they try and sand pencil out. What actually happens, because graphite is so soft, as you're sanding, you're actually abrading the timber and forcing the graphite in deeper. So to get a pencil line out, you're actually putting dips in the timber. Best way, old-fashioned eraser or pencil rubber. Just rub it out like that. No mess, no fuss. You can ruin a good job by sanding in the wrong places. Just glue that into place and nail it. Drill a couple of holes as we did with the footer or the spreader on the bottom. Make sure that when you do drill these holes, they're within the meat of the shelf they're going to get nailed into. And I'll put a couple of skew nails in here as well, as I did with the bottom. Touch of glue. As before, if there's any bits of glue that's creeped through like it has here, wash it off. Now back to the bottom. This is dry. Just clean that putty off. All right, now grab the molding. And what we do is cut it at 45 degrees so it wraps around the sides and along here and down the other side. I found it easier, instead of trying to deal with a large piece of timber like this, make sure you overestimate. So this is 235, I'd cut two bits at 300 or thereabouts. And then do the same with the front piece to make sure it's oversized. Now we've got to cut the mitres on it. Now it depends whatever you've got in your shop. If you've got a drop saw or a docking saw, radial arm saw, use that. You could use a table saw. I've got an old hand mitre saw box, but I'm not moving this bookcase so I can use it. I'll dock these on a drop saw. But make sure that it's nice and precise, 45 degrees. And do the 45 degrees first before you cut the square end to length. That way, if you've got any adjustments to make on the 45, you can do it and you've still got a little bit of fat left on this end. Now how you fit it, it's personal preference. I personally like to start at one end and work my way across. Some people like to put the middle one on first and then put the two sides on. So really, whatever you're comfortable with. It's a question of lining up this shoulder, or this shoulder here, level with the end of the cover piece. And also flat to the sides. It's handy too if you use the other piece. Once you get that nice and square, just hold that in place, mark the back, and then just go and dock that off. And once you're happy with that, slide the other one up, mark it, and then cut your mitre. And then the last bit, same, slide it up so it meets, and then just mark the back here, and then just cut down that line. And I know this flies in the face of everything I've said about timber moving, but sometimes there have to be exceptions. And by having this skirting on here, really it's minimal the amount of damage that the expansion and contraction can do right down this end of the board. Let's just hold it up and we'll see how it looks. Remember to get rid of any excess glue that squeezed through when you're putting the skirting on. And I think it's starting to look all right. Now in part 6 and the final part of this bookcase project, we'll fit the top, we'll put the moulding on, we'll fill all the holes up, we'll give it a really good sand and put a really good finish on it. So until then, and we meet again in the shed, this is Steve, pulling the shed door down on another episode and saying, remember to keep it sharp, but more importantly, keep it safe and enjoy your woodwork. And if you like what we do, please like us on Facebook. And if you want to know more, join up the e-workshop at woodworkingmasterclass.com.au. Stay safe. See you later. Bye for now. G'day, Steve here, Woodworking Masterclass. You know, when I need hardware or any bits and pieces, this is where I come. Masters Parkinson, near Browns Plains in Queensland. But with almost 60 stores nearly Australia-wide, there's bound to be one near you. So why don't you do as I do, go to Masters for your hardware. And if you see me in the Parkinson store, say g'day.